hard on to make anything. First, let me show you what it is. Origami is simply the art of paper, folding paper. Before I go forward, you must know the history of origami to really understand it. Origami origami actually started in China, but the Chinese did not see origami the way the Japanese did and quickly abandoned it. But once the Japanese came to learn of origami, it became a cultural tradition to make origami. The Japanese also gave origami its name. Ora means fold and kami means paper. You may be wondering why they named it origami instead of origami. This is because of the phenomenon the Japanese language called rindaku. Rindaku is where you change the first letter sound in the second word of a compound word. So in this case, changing the K, sound of the K to the sound of a G. So what can origami be used to make? Origami can be used to make anything from a simple 30-stick step crane to a 560-step rack crane. Yes, I did say simple 36 steps. A number of basic folds is to create the creases necessary for later product. Origami has many levels of difficulty. And you can see there's this really easy elephant, this harder elephant, and this three-dimensional elephant. Or you can go straight from simple elephant to more complex ones, depending on how good you are. You can also fold more complex shapes like a dragon, an arachnid, and a cobra. You can also make furniture, just don't try to sit on it. However, origami is not only for the paper. Lots of people use origami for the main idea of folding to put it into air conditioning. As I researched for my passion project, I found it particularly fascinating that even organizations like NASA use origami. NASA's large rovers like Curiosity and Opportunity are very useful, but they can't fit into small places on Mars. Recently, NASA invented a new robot that was inspired by origami. This robot could fold itself up and go into little places on Mars. Origami, in addition to shapes, also comes in various sizes. Did you know the smallest origami crane ever made was made out of a paper that was 1 millimeter by 1 millimeter, 0.1 millimeter by 0.1 millimeter. The artist who made the smallest crane, Mr. Naito, made it using a microscope and special tools he invented himself. And there's Mr. Naito's work. Also, the biggest crane in the world was 215 feet wide, and it was made by an American Jim Rockford. This is a big studio. What I enjoyed most about origami is with practice, I proceeded quickly from simple cranes to three-dimensional figures, like a pyramid. Some also help me connect to math concepts we learned, like in the 3D shape unit, we use 3D shapes so they can use that in the music. You can even make a cool one. As you can see, this is actually origami. When I started learning, when I found time as a waiting for food at a restaurant or on a plane or train. This, you all probably all have some waiting time in your life where you have some waiting time in your life where you don't really have anything to do. I used my waiting time to make origami, and now you can see where it has led me, like this turtle. You can also, so in my perspective, origami is one of the best ways to entertain yourself. doing it, don't forget to tell everybody else.